Today's videos are brought to you by Ranjan Motors, located at 139 Dutugamana Street, Kohula. Come check them out if you're interested in getting a new or used.
How's it going, my car dudes? Liam here from the Car Dudes channel. Today, I am proud to present you all a full in-depth review of the all-new 2018 Toyota Landcruiser Prado. Long time request from a lot of people. But this one is fresh off the boat from Japan. Just got off the boat last night, actually. So I got the first Prado that got imported by Ranjan Motors. So as always, I'm gonna give you guys a full in-depth review of it. I'll show you guys the interior and the exterior of the car. So as always, sit back, relax, and enjoy. Trunk, you can of course pop the glass. You can pop the glass like this, with this little button. Or you can open the full tailgate. Now as you can see, we do have the third row in place. They are power, of course. And of course, with the third row down, you have a cavernous amount of space. The second row is 60-40 split folding. You do have cup holders in here. This is to sort of, I guess, anchor, if you will, your seatbelt speaker. And in here we have some storage as well as your jack tools. In here we also have a power outlet and of course two cup holders for the kids' drinks, because that's really what these seats are made for. I'll put them back up. So yeah, not a bad sized trunk at all. Coming to the back seat. Do have a nice grab handle here. I'm not gonna keep my feet in because the carpets aren't in. But I spent like 3 years of my life in the back seat of a Prado. And legroom is always pretty good. Headroom of course is pretty good with these trucks, and shoulder room isn't too bad either. We do have a center armrest. I can't fold it down because of the protective plastic. And of course, we do have some seat back pockets, as well as a 12-volt power outlet. Overall, not a bad back seat at all. New key fob for the new Prado. It is Toyota's newer style key, upgraded from their silver kind of more rectangular key. This is more curvy and more elegant, if you will. Got some nice aluminum going around it. Your lock, your unlock, and your glass popper. This does have smart key access, so as long as you have the key fob on you, touch the ribbed pattern on any of the driver or passenger door handles. One beep indicates locking, and also so does folding in the mirrors. And to unlock the car, just grab the back of the door handle. And two beeps indicates unlocking, followed with the mirrors folding out. The exterior color of this Prado is known as Blizzard Pearl. And it does have power running boards and features a full beige leather interior, perforated of course. Very nice upgraded interior from the old model. With that smart key access, this Prado does have push button start. All you need to do is make sure you have the key fob in the vehicle, put your foot on the brake, and press the button to go. Very nice. Rev.
Definitely sounds good.
It does have a 4-spoke leather-wrapped steering wheel. Electrically assisted, very smooth. This does have a 6-speed automatic transmission with Tiptronic shifting. Does have a backup camera with guidance lines and a 360-degree view. The parking brake.
Alright, so let's go ahead and cut on the automatic headlamps. Fog lights are already on, high beams, the hazards. All the windows are fully automatic. We will pop the hood. And we'll check out the exterior. This Prado has a 2.7-liter inline 4-cylinder producing 163 horsepower and 170 foot-pounds of torque, has a 0-60 time of 12.5 seconds and a top speed of 175 kilometers an hour. The Toyota Prado is one of the most reliable, capable, versatile, and family-friendly SUVs out there. The TRJ150 Prado has been around for quite a while, making its debut in 2009. However, this new facelift of the TRJ150 definitely looks fairly modern and is a nice upgrade from the older look, which has been around since 2013. The Prado has exceptionally good on- and off-road handling, with a smooth ride from either of the two petrol engines, to the comfy supportive seats which will keep you comfortable on long trips. There are three engines to choose from this 2.7-liter 4-cylinder to a turbocharged 2.8-liter diesel and to a 4-liter petrol V6. In my opinion, the petrol V6 is the best out of the three.
Coming to the interior, power windows, locks and mirrors, full power driver's seat with lumbar support. Down here we have your accelerator and brake, your fuel cap release, your ambient lighting switch for the ambient lighting, the side steps, headlight washers, your power mirrors, your start button, storage in the door with cup holders. To the interior, we do have dual zone automatic climate control. We do have fan speed, recirculation off. This is to adjust the digital clock. Your different zones, front and rear defrost, dual and AC, auto, as well as your hazard lights. Coming down here, we do have a little bit of storage. And in here, we have some cup holders. As you can see, I'm making good use of that. And we also do have the four-wheel drive transfer case, your traction control and second start, which will make the vehicle start in second. Premium 12-speaker audio system. Very nice sound.
This is your infotainment system. Obviously, this is all in Japanese, so I do not understand anything. It does have Bluetooth connectivity, AM, FM radio, you know, all the standard stuff. You can play DVDs off of it, you know, all the fancy stuff. Coming down here, we do have heated seats, 12-volt power outlet, as well as a USB and AUX port, RIP iPhone 7, 8, and 10. We have a little bit of storage in here. And opening up this, we have our two-tier storage, a little bit of storage in there for like your wallet, and passport, or ID, you know, that sort of stuff. And big storage in here for like, I don't know, whatever big things you'd be carrying. The steering wheel is very nice. This is actually taken out of the big Landcruiser, so it's an upgrade from this old steering wheel. And it's pretty nice. You got some steering wheel controls. This is to adjust the display here. So as you can see, music, your radar guided cruise control and your blind spot monitoring, your settings, your fuel economy, you know, and which way your wheels are turned, which is pretty handy. And of course we have the tire pressure, which you can actually monitor the tire pressure of the spare wheel, which is pretty cool. I've never seen that before. Gauges, of course, are also all new. They are more, they don't have those sort of clock venicle things that the older Prado had. They're more clean and more modern, in my opinion. They look sort of like the big Landcruiser. Very nice. Materials on the dashboard, everything is very, very soft. Prados have always been known to have good build quality. Everything's very nice. We have some nice leather sort of footrests here. This is taken straight out of the Fortuner. We got our camera views right here. Four-way. Here you got mirror controls, everything like that. We do have a mirror right here to keep an eye on the kids. Also, double acts as a sunglass container. And we do have a full power one touch sunroof, which is pretty cool. I'm gonna close it because it's like 110 degrees outside and I do not want to boil. Like I said, auto dimming rear view mirror, glove box, pretty decent. Comfort wise goes, the Landcruiser Prado has always been known to have a very, very menacing driving position. You sit high up so you can see everything along the road. I got plenty of thigh support, plenty of leg room, plenty of headroom as well, and shoulder room isn't too bad either. Everything here is very well built. Obviously it's a Toyota, right? So it's known to be great build quality. Everything here just feels a little bit more premium than the older Prado. The older Prado seemed to be a bit agricultural, you know, because everything was a bit sort of old school. Now Toyota has sort of stepped their game and it's sort of more of a, it's more Lexus-y, if you will, if you can take the term like that. It's a little bit more Lexus-y. Everything's a bit more cleaner. I like it compared to the older Prado. Alrighty. We'll turn it off. Well everyone, thank you all so much for watching my review on the all-new 2018 Toyota Landcruiser Prado. As always, let me know what you guys think of the review and leave some suggestions of cars I should review in the comment section below. Like I said, thank you all so much for watching and I will see you guys in my next video. Drive safely till then.